Shalom, shalom. I'd like to start off by giving the honor and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashim Yahushai, Ba'ashim Makat Kadash. Giving double honors to the elders and apostles, a great millstone. You told us this truth, and we're out here for the lost sheep of the house of Israel, being so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. According to the Bible, you are the true biblical Jews. You are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. In these last days, we have to repent and keep the commandments of Yahweh, which is the name of God, that you call him God in ignorance. And Yahweh Shai and Mashiach, who you call Jesus Christ, our Savior, the Israelites, so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. We're out here to call the remnant of our people back to your nationality, your God-given nationality. We are not Puerto Ricans. We are not Mexicans, Salvadorians. These are my words. These are man-made names. God called you Israelites, according to the Bible, to history, archaeology. Black is a color. Brown is a color. These are my words created to label our people by the so-called white man. We have languages that we speak that do not belong to us. They are not part of our heritage. You so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. It says in the book of Revelation, chapter 17 and verse 1. Revelation chapter 17 and verse 1. And there came one of the seven angels, which had the seven vials, and talked with me, saying unto me, come hither, and I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters. The great whore that sits upon many waters is America, mystery Babylon great, spiritually Sodom and Egypt. Spiritually, Sodom and Gomorrah. This is America. This is that great whore spoken of in Revelation chapter 17, verse 2, with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of the fornication. That goes into the doctrine and philosophies perpetrated by America, spiritually Babylon great. This is that great whore that sits upon many waters. The many waters are peoples, nations, tongues, cultures, the melting pot. This is what you call America. This is that great whore of Revelation chapter 17. This says Revelation 17 verse 5. And upon the forehead was the name written, mystery, Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots, and abominations of the earth. Why? Because America is a land that perpetrates abominations. Homosexuality, transgenderism. You have things like the mixing of nations, the mixing of peoples. And that's not what God said in the beginning. God made male and female, and he made each nation to be with their own people. But the so-called white man, through his wine, which is a similitude of philosophy. These are philosophies that he pushes out. Let's all be together. Let's all unite. Well, you read about that in Genesis, in the Tower of Babel. Babel means confusion. This land, which is that great whore, is full of confusion. The peoples are confused. They don't know their heritage. They follow after the ways of the so-called white man, which his name is Esau, biblically. Genesis 25 and 25. He came out all red like a hairy garment. And this book is not a book of religion. This is a book of a nationality of people from beginning to end. This is a book of records. So we're out here to call back you so-called Black, Hispanic, Native Americans, back to your nationality, back to your heritage, back to your language, and to recall you out of this great war in these last days. Because we have things that are coming to pass that Yahushua Mashiach, who you call Jesus Christ, spoke of. He said there will be great wars, great famines, and great wars coming upon Babylon the Great and upon the whole earth. You read about it in Jeremiah chapter 30, the time of Jacob's trouble, when the so-called white man is tired of your shit, of your other nations. And what he's going to do, he's going to put you under subjection to his new system, digital currency. Revelation chapter 13, we're talking about a brand, which he's going to brand you like cattle. Why? Because he knows his time is short, and there's nothing you can do against him, because the Heavenly Father set him up, Yahweh, meaning he exists. So he set him up. He already gave him the counsel. He gave him his instructions upon his bed throughout time. Which is why, if you do your research, 1776, the so-called Illuminati was created. This was not created put to give you all a position in his kingdom. This was created because he knew that his time would be short in the latter days. Why? Because he's a cursed seed. Why? Because he sheds the blood of the saints, which are the so-called Black, Hispanic, Native Americans. And the ICBM missiles will come to Mystery Babylon Great, which is America, and melt this whole land and the people in it. Why? Because this land was created off iniquity. The rape, robbery, and murder of our Native American brothers. This land was built upon the blood and the sweat of our Negro brothers and the so-called Hispanics. So you have to pay. And how is this going to happen during the time of the midst of World War III? During the time of Revelation chapter 13? This man knows that there are many of you and few of him. He has a low birth rate. His people are multiplying as they should. And they knew this even way back then. This is why you cannot stop this truth. Because we have the truth. The truth is not in religion. This is not a book of religion. This is a book of the so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, subjugating your other nation, and the so-called white man, and the new heaven, which will be established on planet Earth, under Yahushua HaMashiach, who you call Jesus Christ, under Yahweh, meaning he exists. So the Heavenly Father set up this man to subdue you. He gave him the sword. His sword is the blessing. Are you that stupid? His sword is the blessing given by his father Isaac. This thing ain't about your other nations. Your other nations ain't shit. This is about Jacob. This is about Esau. This is about the end times. The changing of one kingdom to another. The setting up of Yahweh's kingdom through Yahushua and his elect. And those of the nation of Israel. This is what this thing is about. So we don't give a damn about your scoffers. We don't give a damn what your people think. We're here to fulfill our ministry, our charge, given by the Heavenly Father, through his servants, the prophets. And that's it. We're here to preach this gospel throughout the whole earth, and then the end will come. This is Revelation chapter 17, and verse 5. In the part of forehead was the name written, Mystery, Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. Verse 6. And I saw a woman drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Yahushua. Martyr in the Greek means witness, because we are witnesses of the things that the Heavenly Father said will come to pass in this land, in the United Lines Roman Empire, which is America. You see it in the customs, you see it in the architecture, you see it in the pillars. The pillars you see right in front of me. You see it in their courthouses. You see it in their calendars. You see it in their pagan practices. So this is Mystery Babylon Great. And you other nations are drunk. You don't know what the hell you're doing. And you will know that this man will come upon you with great wrath, which is coming soon. This man will burn you like cattle, which is coming soon. This man's military will overthrow the streets, which is coming soon. Internment camps, it's coming soon. Why? Because you are rebellious people. You are the nations, and the majority of our people follow after them. Which is why you read about sheep being led to the slaughter. And this is what's going to happen. The Mystery Babylon Great, and it's coming soon, and you cannot stop it. So we're calling back the remnant of our people that will hearken, you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. Repent. Return back to the Heavenly Father. Seek the wisdom of His book. Learn how to prepare for the things that are coming upon the earth. Which is death, famine, wars. And your gold will not save you. Your cars will not save you. Your material possessions will not save you in the day of wrath, in the day of the Almighty. Allah Shaddaya, meaning in the Hebrew, demon-like power. Why? Because He set up this man to be the sword of the earth. Especially in these days. So you rebels will get purged out, you other nations, and two-thirds of our people, for falling after this man's philosophy, for falling after the way of wickedness. This is Numbers, chapter 35, verse 33. This is the book of Numbers, chapter 35, verse 33. And you shall take, verse 33, so you shall not pollute the land wherein ye are, for blood, it defileth the land. And the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein, but by the blood of him that shed it. Starting with the so-called white man and the destruction that is coming upon the earth to the other nations for strengthening his hand, for oppressing God's chosen people throughout the earth, mainly in Babylon Great, which is America. Which is why we have things like the brand of the beast, Revelation chapter 13 coming soon, great war, great famine. Why? Because you reap what you sow. That is what the Holy Bible says. So we have World War III coming. We have a brand. This man is going to brand you like cattle. It's coming. We have great death coming. Starting with that ICBM missiles coming upon Babylon Great. Which is America, during the midst of Revelation chapter 13. The brain of the beast is technology. He's going to put that in your body. This is all coming very soon, which is why we're out here to call those who believe in our testimony back unto the Heavenly Father. And the time of Jacob's trouble is also the time of the trouble of the other nations. Why? Because you've been rebellious. And now the recompense will be upon your own head. Thus saith Yahweh. Thus saith the Holy Bible. for the land cannot be cleansed but by the blood of him that shed it. So you have missions come upon Babylon, great America. You have great death. You have wars. You have famine. This is Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 5. The book of Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 5. Overseas. The rod of my anger and the staff in their hand is my indignation. Isaiah 10 and 5, over Assyria, the rod of my anger and the staff in their hand is my indignation. So the modern day Assyria is Babylon Great, which is also known the land of the north, which is also known the daughter of the Chaldeans. This is known as the Valley of Death. The light is as darkness. Verse 12. Therefore, it shall come to pass that when the Lord Yahweh hath performed his whole work upon Mount Zion and upon Jerusalem, I will punish the fruit of the staff of the king of Assyria and the glory of his high looks, starting with this man's structure, his lifeline, which is Babylon Great, which is America, which is why this man's system is being shut down. And you got them scoffers, your own people are going to deliver you up, put you in camps. Why? Because you're rebellious. So it says, Isaiah 10 and 12, I will punish the fruit of the stout of the heart of the king of Assyria and the glory of his high looks. So this place, which is spiritually Assyria, this man built this place off of blood, off of our blood, off of our Native American brothers, off our Negro brothers. Which is why this man's system, since 1969, began, this is the beginning of his downfall. And this same thing happened in Rome. Their infrastructure decayed. Which is why America, their infrastructure is decaying. The system is decaying. The monetary system. We have things like digital currency being introduced. So America is finished. And you, all your people are finished. And he's going to punish your high looks in that day, which is soon. A lot of people think this will continue forever. This has a set time. Isaiah chapter 10, verse 13. For he said, by the strength of my hand I have done it, and by my wisdom that I am prudent. Because so-called white man, since 1776, when he established his secret societies, he knew what the Bible was about. He knew who God's chosen people were. He knew what was going to happen in these days.
They're ready in 2 seconds.
So he used that to make his plans to subjugate all nations, starting with Babylon the Great. Which is why you have this thing that's happening worldwide. And you think you're putting everything together. You think you're joining together. But really, this man is setting you up for his plan. The plan of the beast. The plan you like cattle. And you're locked to your own destruction. Unless you are an Israelite. Unless you return to the Heavenly Father. Repent. Keep the commandments. Come back to your nationality.
What's up, buddy?
You are the nations are finished. You should never trust your enemy. The devil that the Bible speaks of, that's the so-called white man. The dummy. Well, I am prudent. I have removed the bounds of the people. I have robbed their treasures. I have put down the inhabitants like a valiant man. Which is why this man is going to come with his armies, with his internment camps. And the end all be all is that a lot of people are going to die. So here's what we're out here to tell you. We're out here to warn you. Mainly those that believe in your testimony. The remnant of you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. Which we are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. And we're out here coming back on people in these last days. And letting you know what will come to pass. Isaiah chapter 10 verse 14. And my hand have bound as a nest the riches of the people. And as one gathereth eggs that are left, have I gathered all the earth. And there was none that moved the wings or opened the mouth or beat. Verse 10, shall the axe boast itself against him that had healed, that had made him? Or shall the saw magnify itself against him that shaketh it? As if the rod should shake itself against them that lift it up. Or as if the staff should lift it up itself, as if it were no good. So the so-called white man will not finish his new world order, will not set up his new system. And your other nations are going to be put to the slaughter by his military, through internment camps, through his brand, his technology that he's going to put in your body. The new council will not come to pass either. Why? Because that is what the Heavenly Father made and proclaimed through his words since the beginning. This is why you rebels are finished. The Heavenly Father is going to deliver you up to the sword, which is this man, his military, his system, his technology. What are you going to do when your rivers dry up? What happened during the time of the famine, during the time of Egypt? The people saw the fields. They saw what they had. And when nothing was left, you had to sell yourself, your body. This is this man's end all be all. This man has the banks, dummy. This man has you in his control. And he's using you rebellious other nations and the majority of our people to set it up. Which is why the book of Ezekiel says he was wiser than Daniel. Luke chapter 16, the children of this world are wiser than the children of light. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 23, verse 17. Isaiah 23, verse 16. So this man knows all things, the so-called white man, Esau, Edom, the red man, Genesis 25 and 25. He came out all red like a hairy garment. And this is talking about the city of Tyre, which he took over. Just like the many lands he took over, the many customs that he took over. He took the blueprints, and he's executing them now in these latter days. This is Isaiah 23 and verse 16. This is talking about Tyree. And then the Hamite land, the land of the Hamites. It was a great merchant city, which are the Africans today. They are not the Negroes. They're two distinct people. The Negroes are Israelites. They're Shemites, sons of Shem. When the earth was repopulated, you had Shem, Ham, Japheth. After the flood, after the deluge, these are the sons of Ham. They're not the same people. So it says, Isaiah 23, verse 16, take your heart, go about the sea, thou harlot, thou hast been forgotten. Make sweet melody, sing many songs, that thou mayest be remembered. This is Tyree, the great city, merchant city. Which is why you had Alexander the Great. He conquered that city in 330 BC. He conquered the Grecians. He took on their customs, which he still uses today. So he knows all things. Tell me. Isaiah 23 and 17. And it shall come to pass after the end of 70 years. Then Yahweh will visit Tyree, which is, this is the merchant city in the regeneration. This is a regeneration of that city. Which is why it says, Revelation chapter 17, she committed whoredom with all nations of the earth. Isaiah 23 verse 17, and it shall come to pass after the end of 70 years that Yahweh will visit Tyree, and she shall turn to her hire and shall commit fornication with all the kingdoms of the world upon the face of the earth. This is that land today, Babylon the Great. Spiritually Sodom and Egypt, the north country, the daughter of the Chaldeans. So this man knows all things. And he's making his counsel work. Why? Because the Heavenly Father set him up. This is Isaiah chapter 24. In verse 4, the earth mourneth and fadeth away. The world languisheth and fadeth away. The haughty people of the earth do languish. And Yahusha Mashiach spoke of these things. There will be great bitterness, great tumult in the last days. So the haughty people languish. Why? Because of this man, the so-called white man. He's spreading wickedness throughout the earth, deception, through his philosophy, through his religion. God is not dealing with religion. God is dealing with the chosen people. You so-called black, Hispanic, Native Americans. So it says, Isaiah 24 and 4, the earth mourneth and fadeth away, the world languisheth and fadeth away. All the people of the earth do languish. Why? Because this man is the perpetrator of the confusion upon the earth. And you are the nations, the two-thirds of our people, following after this man, and you're drunk. You're spiritually drunk. You're supposed to be with your own people. You're not supposed to be with mixed in. That's causing confusion